is a special presentation of the Simulation Football League.
Breaks out of it. Still going, Johnny English! And English will score! Touchdown, Renegades! He caught it between two defenders! OKC is taking the lead! Matsumoto back to throw. He's in trouble again! This is insanity from Jordan Gray! Look at Gunner! 20, 10, it's a runaway! Touchdown, Gunner! It's H.O. Oh, he made three people miss! H.O. breaks a tackle! He's done it again! Touchdown! Hand off to Snowden up the middle, now tries to cut it right. Beautiful move by Snowden! He's in the open field! Midfield, 40, 30, 20! Richard Snowden to the half! Touchdown, Dragons! Back to pass, looking for the football, and it is recovered by Orlando at the 17. High formation, handoff to Overstreet, around the right-hand side, Overstreet picks up a block, and there he goes, Overstreet, touchdown!
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Louisville, Kentucky, Blue Sun Stadium for a rematch of the Teal Conference Championship from Season 6. The Houston Hyenas are in town as the Hyenas and Wolfpack clash for the fourth time in the last year. Good evening, everyone. I am your play-by-play commentator, Kevin Irvine. These two teams enjoying exact opposite seasons through the first 2 weeks. Houston's 0-2 and has a new head coach at the helm, Greg Morris. Louisville is 2-0, and despite all the turnovers, putting up yards, putting up points, putting up wins, the coin toss, Thursday Night Football is next.
Your call.
Give us tails.
Houston wearing their alternate uniforms tonight, honoring the movie The Program. And Louisville in their alternate grays this evening. And we are just about ready to go. Louisville trying to go 3-0. Houston trying to put the league on notice. They're not dead yet. Louisville and Houston, the ball's on the tee. Wolfpack, take it, we're on our way. From the 9-yard line, actually, return pass to 20 by new acquisition Jamari Nito, the wide receiver, the slot wide receiver wearing number 0, and he returns it up to the 27-yard line. So Houston's offense will start with the football first. Their quarterback is Steve Abuaji, 6'5", 219. The rookie, of course, no Courtney Coleman here tonight. Released in the offseason, but of course he was the one that made that winning play here against Louisville. Darnell Black takes the carry, and Darnell Black bounces off the tackle and nearly got the first down. In fact, I thought that he did. It's going to be second and short at the 36-yard line. Looked like a 10 yards full gain to me. Again, Houston in their alternate program uniforms tonight. Black helmets, white jerseys, gold pants, red numbers, and a red and gold trim. Louisville in the blue lids, gray jerseys, gray pants, blue numbers, and the very slight white trim down the side. Second down and inches at the 36, and the handoff on a counter will go to Black, and Black's got a first down and more to the 41. And why not bring up Darnell Black's stats right away since he started so well? Look at that stat on the right side. 647 yards on 65 carries for 7 touchdowns for Darnell Black in 3 meetings with Louisville. That's almost 10 yards a carry. He has had the Wolfpack number. First and 10. Obwasi back to throw. Deep shot down the field. Wide open. It's caught inside the 10. It's a touchdown for Houston. Nighty night, Louisville. D.R. Sim with the score. And Houston is off to a fantastic start here on the road tonight. Just an exceptional pass down the field. Obwasi really let it rip. I didn't know he had that in him. And the Houston Hyenas get on the board in a big way after back-to-back solid runs from Darnell Black. D.R. Sim in the end zone, and Houston's up 6. Extra point for the Hyenas. Laughing all the way in the end zone on their opening drive. The extra point is good. And it's Houston 7 and Louisville nothing. What a start. Louisville going to have to compose themselves. Wolfpack defense hasn't been too spectacular through the first 2 weeks. And we'll get to those numbers here in a little while. But just getting started here on Thursday Night Football. And the Hyenas already... with as big of an advantage as they possibly could have. From the 11-yard line, Wolfpack on the return. And the 30, that's Brevin Armstrong on the return. Skeletor P-Funk, not the greatest first 2 weeks of the season. 7 touchdowns, but 10 picks. A quarterback rating of 80.2. He does have 934 yards in 2 games. Funk certainly has had the passing yards, as has this offense, but the turnover differential has not been Louisville's friend, and they may not be able to turn the ball over too much here tonight if they want to get a win. Out of the eye is Funk with a 3-4 defensive look. Funk will shovel it off to Overstreet, and Overstreet picks up 3. Haven't seen much of Overstreet in the passing game to start this year, but he gets the first catch of the night. Of course, Louisville's offense is predicated, at least through the first 2 weeks, on their 2 wide receivers outside. Flynn Starbuck, number 2, the former Dallas lawman, and Lawrence Kirkland, number 3, the former Honolulu legend. Kirkland, 6'6", 207. The tight end is D.D. Ritter, number 48. The slot man, Brevin Armstrong, number 13. Running back is Overstreet. And the quarterback is Funk, of course. Funk back to pass on 2nd and 7. It's picked off at the 38-yard line and returned to the 32. Pass intercepted by Matthew Boozer. It's a first down for Houston 2 minutes into the game. Boozer steps right in front of a crossing route and gets, I believe, his first career interception, and Houston could not have asked for a more brilliant start. And Funk with his 11th interception. And Louisville's turnover problems continue. Obwasi handed off to Black. Turns and hands it off and picks up 1, does Darnell. Billy Joe Gatlin on the tackle. Let's meet the Wolfpack defense. Led up front by Andre Khrushchev, number 58. 2 really strong corners on the outside. Lucius Sanders and the rookie Charlie Monk wearing 24 and 0 respectively. Free safety, Billy Joe Gatlin, number 47. Strong safety, number 37, Aaron Tolbert. Defensive tackle, number 99, Rick O'Reilly. 4 receivers empty set now for Obwasi. And Houston back to throw. Over the middle, that pass is complete. Just outside the 25 to the 26. That's D.R. Sim again with the catch. It'll bring up Houston's first third down of the ball game. 3rd and 4 at the 26. I'm your play-by-play commentator, Cameron Irvine. You're watching Thursday Night Football on the SFL Network. Houston and Louisville, a rematch of the Teal Conference Championship. The first 3 minutes is all about the Hyenas. Darnell Black on the carry. He's got blockers in front of him. And Black cannot find any space. Seems like he did a lot of running just for 2 yards. And Louisville's defense gets the stop on 4th down. And we'll bring on the kick unit. Or not. 4th and 2. Houston's offense still on the field. Talk about confidence. That's a full 2 yards as well. I'd be shocked if Houston does anything with this. They're really, ballsy here in the first quarter. Down to 5 on the play clock, and Houston calls a timeout. So Houston, I don't know who they were trying to fool, but didn't fool the Wolfpack, and they burn a silly timeout here in the first 4 minutes. So the drive ends in a bit of a thump for Houston's offense as Greg Morris, the new head coach, having a word with his quarterback, who he is getting acquainted with, a Bwaji 6'5", 219. And the Hyenas will try to make it 10-0 still. A two-possession lead this early would be beneficial for Houston. A 40-yard kick from the right hash. And everyone up to block it for Louisville. Snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is on its way. And the kick is good. Field goal is around or right down the middle and a little bit towards the left, but no trouble there on the kick, and Houston is up 10-0. Simulation Football League is presented by Dak Stats and OBS Studio all season long as the SFL celebrates its seventh season. It's our third with Dak Stats, first with OBS. Tremendous partners from the 9-yard line. Armstrong on the return, and Armstrong is put down pretty easily at the 27. .713 to go, and Skeletor P. Funk will try to shake off the early interception. There's a look at Kanye Rockefeller, the star free safety for this Houston defense, and he is no doubt the leader of the defensive backfield. Flip to Overstreet. There's a flag on the play. Tried to hook up Overstreet up the middle. I think they're going to get Louisville for an ineligible receiver.
Ineligible receiver, number 76.
So that's a 5-yard penalty. Louisville very sloppy here in the early going. No first downs, a turnover, and a penalty, and it'll be first and 15. Like to give a shout out to Brevin Armstrong's granddad, Bruce Armstrong. He is viewing his second ever SFL game, and we're happy to have you here. Thursday night football, Houston up early as Armstrong and the Wolfpack offense trying to work. That pass is caught, but just a 4-yard pickup. That's the first catch for the men on the outside. Flynn Starbuck with the catch, and let's meet the Hyena defense. Linebackers Alonzo Hamilton, number 52. We all know Matthew Boozer. He got the pick on that last drive. Cornerback number 24, Aaron Arrington, and number 33, J.D. Lawson. Strong safety, Noah Martin, number 20, and Kanye Rockefeller, the free safety, number 7. Funk back to pass on second down, 11. Deep ball from Funk, and that pass is caught wide open past the 30, 20, 10, and a touchdown for Lawrence Kirkland. We thought we may see some fireworks here tonight. And it is just beginning here in Kentucky. This is the aggressive approach Louisville has brought to the table in season 7. We talked about earlier in the broadcast how Funk is averaging nearly 10 yards an attempt through the first 2 weeks. He is not afraid to just tell his receivers to get out of here. And two deep balls down the field have this game at 10-6. Extra point is good for the Wolfpack, and it's Houston 10 and Louisville 7. If you haven't already, the SFL's documentary, A New Frontier, that I was happy to fly down to Florida to shoot and film. Well, I didn't do the filming. I was filmed, but it was still a fun time despite the humid conditions, which I've heard it's still very, very humid in Florida. Check it out at simulationfl.com. Mito on the return up to the 28. 6:31 to go in the first half, and Louisville just like that has squished the gap to just 3 points.
First and 10.
6:31 to go in the first half. Houston will try to keep some of the momentum they built in a wild first quarter here. Abwaji back to pass and avoids a sack, and the pass is dropped. Tolbert in coverage, but no excuse there for that drop down the field. Second and 10 for Houston, and they're starting to get a little sloppy. Houston offense has D.R. Sim, number 80, and Paul James, number 88, on the outside. Mito's in the slot. The center, number 76, Kyle Perry, is a new signee this week. Running back Darnell Black wears number 28. Out of the shotgun, Abwaji on second down and 10 following the drop. Back to pass. He'll have to check it out short to Black. He was out of bounds. Not a good last few plays for Houston's offense, as they've quickly lost momentum, it would appear. Third down and 10 with 6:24 to go in the first. Franco Sanati with us today. The newest member of Houston will see the field next week. I believe empty backfield as Abwaji on third down passes short of 10, but that is not even close to a first down. Fourth and 7 at the 31, and Louisville's defense tightens up and forces a stop. And they put Funk right back out onto the field three plays later. Not even halfway through the quarter yet. We've got three scores on the board. Houston and Louisville played a very defensive Teal Conference championship game as Armstrong returns up to the 13-yard line. But you see what they've done so far this year, and the scoring defense not good. Houston is dead last, 36 points a game given up. And I want you to look at that yards per carry and yards per pass attempt stats, and we'll bring them up one more time as those are the key stats to watch tonight. Really shows the difference in what these two teams have been like over the first couple of weeks. First and 10 at the Louisville 33, and Funk's out of the gun. He'll hand it off to Overstreet, and he lost a yard. Take a look at the yards per carry. Louisville just a little bit over 4 yards a carry, but their passing game has been more prolific. Houston actually averaging more yards every time they run than every time they throw, just 7 yards per pass attempt for Houston through the first 2 weeks. Second and 11 at the Louisville 32. Hyena's up 3, trying to get a stop. Funk to throw, and Funk flips it outside. Houston ready for that. No gain on the play. That is Lawson on the outside making the stop. The former Mahler. Overstreet gets nothing. Under 5 to go in the first. Third and 10 coming up for Louisville.
Third and 10 from your wing.
4:43 to go in the first. Third down and 10 at the 33. Empty backfield out of the shotgun. Ball in the left half for Louisville. Funk to throw. And Funk steps up in the pocket. Fires it. Incomplete. That was Hamilton on the coverage down the field. Andy, the intended receiver, as Louisville really spread him out. But Houston's defense gets a stop, and both defenses starting to settle in here as the Wolfpack will have to punt for the first time tonight.
Ready.
Your wing has selected the punt. Number 0 is D3C.
4:30 to go. Action across the league on SFLN2. Oklahoma City hosting Deion Hawkins and the DC Dragons. Hawkins coming into the night leading the league in rushing. Darnell Black is second, by the way. And on SFLN3, it's the Sioux Falls Sparrows hosting the NYC Sailors as Mito gets a nice punt return up to the 37-yard line. Our next broadcast here on the main network is Sunday night, and it's the 2-1 Orlando Intimidators hosting the 1-2 Baltimore Crabs. Of course, week 4 is rematch week, and Baltimore going back to Orlando will bring back a lot of great memories for those of you that have been here for a couple of seasons. The catch down the field by Thomas Gunner, and when Orlando had that insane game-winning drive as Darnell Black picks up a nice 6 yards, averaging just under 5 yards a carry. That Baltimore-Orlando game for the long time was the SFL record for live viewers at once. Of course, that was broken opening night of this regular season. Second and four at the Houston 43 after the 6 yard run from Darnell Black. Black will take another handoff. Black around the left side. Black gets a couple of blocks. Breaks a tackle. Black is inside the 40 and down to the Louisville 39. Monk and Khrushchev combined on the stop, but it's something about Darnell Black that just gives Louisville so many problems. Just really nice blocking on a little sweep around the end. Good job on the outside by the receivers. That may have been Sim on the outside. First and 10 at the Louisville 39, and Houston is fighting their way down the field. Three receivers, two off to the short side left, and Black will get the handoff again. Black hurdles a defender who was on the ground. I believe that was O'Reilly. Needless to say, Black nearly pulled a muscle, and Monk on the tackle, gain of one. Second and 9 at the 38. Rick O'Reilly is the biggest man in the league, 6'6", 350. 3:12 to go, first quarter, two in the backfield again. Sim is at the bottom of the screen, defended by Sanders, I believe. The handoff to Black once more to the left side, and Louisville this time was ready for it, no gain. Three straight runs that direction, and Talofa makes the tackle. Under 3 to go in the first quarter. Blue Sun Stadium, Louisville, Kentucky. The 2-0 Wolfpack trying to keep Houston winless from the Bluegrass State. 2:40 to go in the first quarter. And with an empty backfield, a Washington will throw. And he steps up in the pocket. He's going to be sacked. Back at the 42-yard line and outside of field goal range. First sack of the night for either team. That's Andre Kaysen, the strong safety and former WAFL player. Kaysen's been around a long, long time, and he gets the sack on the safety blitz. Well executed on third down there by Louisville.
You better get used to it, because it's coming again.
Houston will try to pin the Wolfpack deep here. After a flurry of scores in the first 4 minutes, as Armstrong calls for a fair catch at the 11-yard line, things have started to settle back down. How prolific has Louisville's offense been in the first 2 weeks? Well, they're second in scoring offense, total offense, and pass offense. They're third in third down conversions, and they are fourth in first downs a game. That's pretty good, despite the turnover problems. First and 10 at the 11-yard line. Louisville down 3, despite the early interception by Matthew Boozer. Funk is changing the play. He'll hand it off to Overstreet. Overstreet is smacked in the backfield. That's Farnsworth Bentley, who's got 3 sacks in the first 2 weeks for this Houston Hyena squad. And I failed to mention him. My mistake, 6'7", 280, failed to mention him when I was going over the defensive stars. But he has made a big impact on that Houston defensive front. And if it wasn't for the two defensive ends in Minneapolis playing last night, he'd still be leading the league in sacks. Overstreet takes the swing, no gain. Houston is not playing that tonight. Hamilton on the stop. It's third and 10 back at the 10-yard line. And the defenses have really sharpened their teeth.
Third and 10.
Third down and 10 at the 10. Funk empty backfield. Going deep down the field. Pass is incomplete. Wow, I can't believe no one came down with that football. I couldn't see it. Let's take a look again at what happened here. Oh, man, right off the hands of Noah Martin, the strong safety. That should have been a pick.
Great.
Either way, the deep ball falls incomplete, and Houston's defense gets another stop. And Greg Morris has to like the way that the Hyena defense has settled in. Last in the league coming in, giving up 36 points a game. And got off to a horrible start here in the first quarter. And this punt is pretty short. Nito on the return up to the Louisville 41, and Houston's going to end up with great field position. Seconds to go in the first. Week four just around the corner. Cleveland takes on Minneapolis. Carolina takes on Tallahassee also Sunday night. Three receivers, two off to the left side, and a Washington handed off to Black. Oh, Black breaking ankles all over the field. Picks up eight to the Wolfpack 33. Black just crushing people. There's his career stats once again. 5.8 yards per carry over his career. Now it's just his second season in the league, but still, that ain't too bad. Two receivers to the top of the screen, two in the backfield. Coming up on maybe the final play of the first quarter, Black on the left side again, and Black is cut down in the backfield. Houston a little bit too one-dimensional offensively. It'll bring up a third down and three at the Louisville 34. As the Wolfpack are ready and waiting for that run to the left side. End of the first quarter of play. Houston has the lead. 10-7. Three quarters away. Getting their first win. Louisville will have a lot to say. This is the SFL Network. We'll be back after this. Start of the second quarter. Obwazi throws outside. Pass out of bounds. Monk telling us it was incomplete. We may see a challenge. Don't know if Houston wants to risk it this early, especially since they've already lost a timeout. Trying to make him jump. And no challenge from Houston. It was hard to see because the pass was literally right at the sticks. And instead of kicking a 51-yard field goal, Houston will punt it away and try to pin Louisville inside the one-yard line. This punt is a really bad punt. From the 12, and Louisville's actually going to return it to the 15. Golly, why not just go for it? Houston can't even pin Louisville inside the 10-yard line. And then the Hyena special teams unit acted like he wasn't going to return the kick and almost wasn't ready for Armstrong's return. First and 10 of the just shy of the 15 for Louisville. Three receivers, Armstrong in the slot off to the right side. Funk the pass. And Funk going down the middle. Armstrong, the pass is caught at the 31. First down for Louisville. 99 yards in the early going for Skeletor P. Funk. Averaging well over 400 yards passing so far this season. Only Matt Wilson can say the same. And Armstrong gets in the mix with his first catch. First and 10 from your wing, 32 yards. Gain of 16 on the play. Four receivers, four Funk. And he'll hand it off to Overstreet. Overstreet getting some more carries here early on. Overstreet still going to the 46. We saw a very subdued David Overstreet in those first two victories for Louisville. Not the case here tonight, as they're finding a way to get him more involved early on. And it's another Wolfpack first down near midfield. Also should say that Gunnar Durango, outside linebacker number 54, is a new addition to this Hyena squad this week. First down, Wolfpack. Funk back to pass. Pump fake. Now goes middle. That pass is caught to the Houston 40. What a catch this time. It's Ritter, his first of the game. And Funk is really sticking the ball in some tight windows here on this drive. I don't know how Ritter makes this catch. The linebacker had his back turned. That's how. First and 10 of the Houston 40. Hyena defense needs a bit more focus. Two in the backfield, three receivers. Ball on the right hash, nearing scoring position, Funk to pass. And Funk goes down the middle. Oh, a beautiful grab by Kirkland, reaches the big arms out there to make the catch, his second of the game. Another first down of the Houston 25, gain of 16 again. Funk put that a little bit, looked to be too far out ahead of Lawrence Kirkland. Kirkland never ceases to amaze. The string bean makes the play. Back to pass, Funk. Funk is on fire on this drive. That pass is caught again at the 12. Ritter with the play, and Funk staying cool, calm, and collected in the pocket. And this may be Skeletor P. Funk's best drive of the season so far. He was nearly sacked. Not his best pass, but Ritter wide open, and Martin makes the tackle. Louisville looking real solid here on this offensive drive. Four wide receivers to either side. Overstreet's going to get the carry up the middle. And Overstreet picks up two. But a nice job by Hamilton inside to make the play. Second and eight at the 10. .142 yards and a pick for Funk so far in this half. Second and eight at the 10. Five-step drop, back to pass, going end zone. It's picked off in the back of the end zone by Martin. He dropped one earlier in the game, and he makes up for it on this drive. Funk has thrown two picks in the first half, and Martin came flying out of nowhere. Martin was not even the receiver that he was defending. And a heads-up play by the rookie to get the stop, and Houston stays on top.
Let's go.
Could it be another costly turnover for Funk? Noah Martin, that was one of the best interceptions I've seen this season, because that was not even Martin's responsibility. As Abwaji goes down the field, it's dropped right into the hands of Billy Joe Gatlin. Second drop of the night for Houston. I think that may have been the fullback. That is brutal. They give it right back, and it wasn't even the quarterback's fault. A wild first half here, but the score is stuck for the moment at 10-7 Houston. Funk is out of the gun, changing the play, three receivers. Back to pass, swings it outside, out route is caught by Starbuck. Pick up a four, Starbuck a quiet first half. Visit the SFL shop at cafepress.com/simulationfl to get your team gear today. .7:30 to go. Starbucks catching 4 yards. Funk to throw. Funk deep ball left side is knocked away. Excellent play on the outside. Starbuck was the intended receiver. And that was Arrington, who is wearing 25 tonight. Should be 24. So put that note out there. They must have not had the program uniforms made in number 24. So Arrington with the pass deflection intended for Starbuck. Third down and six at the 26-yard line. Funk's out of the shotgun, back to throw. And Funk will fire down the field. Caught! Perfect play to Armstrong at the Hyena 15. This is a real nice quarter for Louisville's passing game, because we're seeing Brevin Armstrong and D.D. Ritter, two guys that are not necessarily a focal point in scouting reports, having a really good first half in the second quarter specifically. Out of the eye. Funk to throw. And Funk will fire it outside. And a lot of room to run. Down to the 10. That's Imbutabe, the fullback. Picks up four. Second down and six. And Louisville knocking on the door again. into scoring position after Noah Martin made that incredible play in the end zone. The fullback for Houston just blows it, and I don't even want to say his name. 6:25 to go in the first half. Houston by three. Trips off the left side. Bunk to throw. Bunk sends it out to Overstreet. Overstreet makes the man miss. And Overstreet near the first down of the six. Rockefeller on the tackle. Third down and one. 6:10 and counting here in the first half. Follow the league on Twitter at SimulationFL. Subscribe to our YouTube and Twitch channels at /SimulationFL. And visit SimulationFL.com for daily updates. 5:52 to go in the first half. Funk's out of the gun on third and one from the six. And Funk will drop the throw. Pump fake now. Funk had a man wide open to the outside, and he blew it. Pass knocked down, but the I don't know if that was Overstreet on the outside or Imbutabe, but there was a guy wide open sipping a pina colada out there, and it's fourth and one. Louisville will have to settle for the field goal, a rare misread from Funk. And Louisville can tie the game with a 22-yard field goal. 22-yard kick for the Wolfpack is up, and we got a tie game. 5:40 to go in the first half. Houston 10, Louisville 10. Reset everything. It's all zeros. High kick to the 8-yard line. Still on the return. He's yet to have a catch tonight, been decent in the return game, and the Hyenas start from the 28. Hyenas wearing their alternate uniforms tonight, honoring the program. Great movie. Louisville is in their alt grades. A Boise decent start. The interception on that last drive, completely not his fault. First and 10 at the 28, ball in the middle of the field, empty backfield with four receivers. Boise back to pass, swings it outside. Pass complete. D.R. Sim with his fourth catch already with 71 yards and a touchdown. Very quiet night so far for Paul James and Eric Vinson. Vinson, the tight end, number 22. I don't think either have received a target. Shotgun and watching. And he flips it outside. Oh, it's dropped! Welcome to the SFL. Jamari Mito drops the ball. And Houston is just having a ton of problems with drop passes tonight. That's their third in the first half. Out of the eye, third and five. Abwaji's got to be real frustrated at this point. Back to pass. And Abwaji's going deep down the field. It's caught! Caught inside the 40, down to the 35. It's Sim again. And Steve Abwaji's just saying, I don't know why I'm throwing to anyone else on the field but D.R. Sim tonight. Because that man continues to come down with big catches. D.R. Sim with five grabs in the first half. First and 10. And Houston is on the outskirts of field goal range. Empty backfield again, four wide. Darnell Black hasn't gotten many looks on this drive. Abwaji's pass caught over the middle. 9-yard pickup, that's Sim again. 113 yards on six grabs for D.R. Sim. So go along with his touchdown that he had in the opening 2 minutes. Second 2K Sports Halftime Report coming up next with first half highlights and stats. Second and one at the 26. Black takes the counter. Black breaks off the tackle. First down to the 22. Monk with the eventual stop. Houston trying to regain their lead. Louisville has not led in this game. As the Wolfpack trying to get revenge for losing that Teal Conference final in devastating fashion. Under 4 minutes to go in the first half. Ball close to the right hash. Receivers two bottom of the screen. Black on the handoff. Picks up five into the red zone of the Louisville 17. Donate, play, win. It's SFL Pick'em. See SimulationFL.com for more details. Pick'em winding down, folks. We'll find out who won week three. And if you're participating in the free Who You Got Pick'em, and you're winning, and you're good at it, why not make some money off of it as Darnell Black makes the catch, but Khrushchev is there immediately on the tackle. Maybe a gain of a half a yard, third down. Sun Stadium chanting defense. Third down and four. 4-2 look out of the defense for the Wolfpack. And Abwaji sees something he doesn't like. He's going to change the call. Let's see what the rookie can do with a loud blue Sun Stadium in his ear. He's going to run it. Right up the middle, and Black spins away and pushes forward. But Rick O'Reilly with the stop. It's fourth and one at the 14-yard line. See if Houston's offense remains on the field. No, they're going to take the points. Nice stop by O'Reilly. Actually, O'Reilly missed on the tackle initially, but Black spun back in his direction. And the 30-yard field goal for Houston to regain the lead is good. 2:12 to go in the first half. Houston 13 and Louisville 10. Kevin Bailey is the kicker. He's 2 for 2 tonight for the Hyenas. Louisville will try one more time before the end of the half to take the lead. And the Houston coaching staff a little torn between whether or not Abwaji made the right call there. Armstrong on the return from the 8-yard line. Armstrong pass 25 and headhunting is Houston's special teams. Armstrong looks a little dazed. Return up to the 29-yard line and 2:08 is on the clock. Houston's up by three. Funk out of the gun with split backs. Funk will hand it off to Overstreet. He's got some blockers. That may have been a block in the back. Overstreet is out in the open. Past the 40, Rockefeller chasing. 30-20. Rockefeller slows him down to the 14-yard line. 57 yards on the run from David Overstreet, and Greg Morris can't believe it. Yeah, I'm not sure if that was a block in the back. It looked like a pretty good block initially. Officials may have missed one there as Louisville is at the Hyena 14-yard line. Two receivers off to the right side. That's Starbuck in the slot. Houston will hope to hold the three. Another run, same play for Overstreet. He cuts it back inside. Bentley on the tackle. 2-yard gain. That'll kill some more time off the clock. Louisville all three timeouts. Houston has two. Before the half, Green also on the stop. Three receivers, two off to the left. The eye, it's going to be a flip to Overstreet. Breaks off a tackle. Overstreet's into the end zone! On the shovel, touchdown Louisville. And they didn't even need 1 minute of the 2 minutes they got. First lead of the night for the Wolfpack. And it comes on a play that's risky, but Louisville knows how to run it well, mostly. They got a penalty on it earlier tonight. And it scores a touchdown for Louisville just before the half. No, AJ, pick six. You can chat on the main chat and watch other games on the network. By going to SimulationFL.com and going to the Game Day channel. It doesn't matter how many times I say it. Now, people just have no idea. 1:20 to go in the first half. Louisville takes a four-point advantage. From the 9-yard line, Mito on the return. Up to the 29. Houston has suffered with three drop passes. One of them resulted in an interception that turned into Louisville points. And the Wolfpack's big play ability has continued here in the first half. D.R. Sim really has been the offense of Houston here in the second quarter. Gun, Abwaji to throw. And he flips it outside. That is Paul James, his first catch. As you look at the quarterback comparison, Funk averaging well over 400 yards a game. So he's a little bit off that here in the first half. Houston trying to avoid going 0-3. Louisville, even with a victory, may not be technically on top of the East Division with Dallas at 3-0. Trips off to the left side for Houston. And Abwaji goes down the middle of the field. That pass is caught at the 42-yard line. That is the tight end, Eric Vinson. That's his first catch. So James and Vinson getting involved here on this in this two-minute offense. Abwaji to throw, going deep down the middle of the field. That pass is caught by Sim. That's just, no, check that. Paul James, my mistake. First and 10 of the Wolfpack, 38. And Abwaji, three straight completions here in the final minute of the half. Flip out to Black. That's his fourth. The four different receivers. That's a 6-yard gain for the Louisville 32. Houston has two timeouts. They're trying to preserve them. Vinson is off to the right-hand side. Bottom of the screen, 33 seconds to go. Abwaji to throw. And Abwaji down the middle again. That pass is caught inside the 20. And a timeout of the 18-yard line. What a drive for Houston. Five different receivers with catches. Terrence Washington with the most recent. Washington, James, Vincent, Black, Sim, all catches in the last 30 seconds. What a brilliant one-minute drive here by the Hyenas. They have one timeout left, and the ball's in the Louisville 18.
Let's go!
Three in the backfield for the first time tonight. And Abwaji's going to flip it out to Black. And Black got just 1 yard. Not sure about the play call at this point in the first half. And they have to hurry here. 12 seconds to go. They're going to try it one more time. Black's got blockers this time. Black inside the 10. He breaks the tackle over the goal line. He got it. Touchdown, Houston. Oh, what a play by Darnell Black. I can't believe he scored, reaching for the goal line. You can't ask for anything more fantastic than that. Touchdown, Hyenas, no review. Wow. What a play just before the end of the half as Black stretches out for the goal line and Houston retakes the lead. The greatest league on the planet. Houston 20, Louisville 17. Let me catch my breath. What a play. Those are the type of plays that win games. Wow. From the 12, Armstrong on the return. Maybe the final play of the half. And he's tackled with 2 seconds to go at the Wolfpack 29. And now Houston needs to defend one more time. I formation here for the Wolfpack. Hyenas up three. And Funk is going to flip it to Overstreet. He dropped the ball, and that's the end of the first half. A very mellow end to the first half of play. Houston 20, Louisville 17, as the two teams hit the locker room, and we take a break. 2K Sports Halftime coming up next. This is the SFL Network. Start of the second half. Louisville gets the ball. Armstrong from the 11 up to the 29. Oh, wild third quarter. Remember what happened last time these two teams played? I have a feeling I'm going to have a rough night again in the second half. First and 10 at the Louisville 29. And the Wolfpack start the third quarter with a run to Overstreet. No gain. Overstreet is averaging 10.4 yards a carry, but most of that on that 57-yard run that yielded a touchdown that, for the moment, put Louisville ahead But Houston with a tremendous one-minute drive to end the first half. Man. 10.5 to go in the third. Out of the gun. Funk. Back to pass. And Funk goes down the field. Oh, what a catch! A beautiful adjustment of the ball. That's Kirkland for the first down. There's nothing you can do about that if you're the Hyena defense. That's just Kirkland making a better play. Watch this adjustment of the football. Rockefeller was in coverage. Kirkland makes the better read and moves the chains. Starbucks been pretty quiet tonight. Kirkland has continued to be a force. And the toss out to Overstreet. He'll break a tackle. Overstreet first down to the 34. Martin wrestles him down, but David Overstreet is running hard tonight. Boozer missed the tackle. Martin cleans it up. Another look at how these two teams compare coming in. Some key stats of the night. Pass efficiency pretty low for both teams. The defenses have been a little better tonight. Of course, Louisville just 4.2 yards a carry coming in. They're averaging over 9. Probably over 10 at this point. Funk back to pass. Funk is running out of time and he's sacked. Loss of 7 yards. Houston's been good at getting pressure on the quarterback. This time it's Elvis Sapp. Yeah, Bentley's initial pressure moved Skeletor P. Funk off to the left, and Bentley got a sack for his teammate. Three wide receivers, Funk to throw, and Funk flips it outside. Pass caught, and a big hit on the sideline by Lawson. Kirkland makes the grab. He's got more yards, but Sim has been the more consistent threat. 6 catches for 113 in that first half, although I could have sworn, oh, that was James. I had to correct myself. I was going to say I thought he had a 7th. Third down and 10 at the Houston 34. Hyenas trying to get a stop just in the nick of time. Back to pass Funk, and Funk outside. Caught for the first down. Armstrong again to the Hyena 24. Really solid night for Brevin Armstrong in the slot. Greg Morris, the new head coach of Houston, has been primarily responsible for trying to reshape this defensive unit. It's worked out decently so far as the Wolfpack sit on 17 points, but driving. Funk back to pass, and Funk steps up, has to check it down, and Overstreet is hit hard, and Overstreet is hurt. Lawson makes the tackle, and Overstreet is injured, and that may not be good. Overstreet takes a big pop. We've seen this time and time again before. You know, we've played over 300 games, and typically when you see a player go down on his shoulder like that, that ain't good. That ain't pretty. That could mean big trouble for Louisville and their undefeated record. It's second down and 10 at the 24. Now, there's certainly no reason why Louisville could not win this game on the arm of Funk. This team averages over 450 yards a game. But J.D. Lawson lays a monster hit here in the third quarter. Funk to throw, and Funk hit as he threw. The pass is nearly intercepted. Bentley applying more pressure. Third and 10 coming up. And I think what happened with Overstreet was totally blindsided by that hit from Lawson because he was too busy shedding the initial attempted tackle. And he spun right into the nasty hit from Lawson. And it's third down and 10. Funk now has 5 wide receivers out of the gun. 3-2 defense out of Houston. Funk to throw, going left side. Pass is caught for a touchdown. Flynn Starbuck over Kanye Rockefeller. And that corner route is run better here in Louisville over the first 3 weeks than it is anywhere else in the league. To perfection. Funk practices that route so often with his receivers in practice all throughout the week. Funk and Kirkland. Another corner route. Beats the defense, and Louisville regains the lead without Overstreet on the field. Extra point for Louisville is good. And neither team has any quit in them tonight. 8:04 to go in the third. Houston 20, Louisville 24. Don't forget the SFL postgame show is coming up next. We anticipate it'll be quite a busy line of phone calls immediately following the conclusion of all the games. It looks like the other two games around the league are ahead of us this evening, so it'll be following the conclusion of this wild game. Take your Collins reaction in the chat. Mito on the return. Mito past the 30, 35, up to the 36. Best return of the night for Jamari Mito. We had such a heavy number of calls last night. We had to cut the show short. SFL's week four coming up, and things are getting mighty interesting around the league. You think it's dramatic now? Wait till week 10, week 12. Four wide receivers, Abwaji out of the gun. Back to pass, lofting it over the middle. Oh, dropped the interception, did Gatlin. That was an easy play to make. That ball got away from Abwaji, his worst pass of the night. Really, his only bad one to my recollection, and Gatlin just simply dropped the pick. A break for Houston there. Second and 10 at the 36. Three receivers, Blacks in the backfield. Abwaji back to pass. Abwaji's pass is intercepted at the 45. And return to the 38. Gatlin got it back. This is the night of redemption for defensive backs. Earlier in the game, Noah Martin dropped an interception, then got one later on. And Billy Joe Gatlin does it on the very next play. Ill-advised pass from Abwaji, and it's all Louisville in the second half despite Overstreet's injury. And this is the story of Louisville's season so far. Just every time you think the deck is stacked against them, all of a sudden you look down and they're still winning the game. Funk out of the shotgun, back to throw. Flips it outside, short, caught, a lot of open room in front of Ritter, I believe. Nope, check that, Armstrong. Pickup of 9 at the Houston 30, and the Hyena defense is going to need to come up with something big here.
Second and one from the Rockets, 29-9.
7:25 to go in the third. Louisville up 4. Out of the eye is Funk. Kirkland, bottom of the screen. Starbuck, top of the screen. 7:15 to go in the third. Louisville by 4. Funk will flip it to Overstreet up the middle. First down. Overstreet to the 20. I'm losing myself. Overstreet is still out of the game due to injury, but it's still a first down up to the 24. The backup running back, I apologize, I don't have it on my roster, but his number's number 23, and we'll get his name in a moment. 255 yards for Funk and 3 touchdowns. Quarterback rating of now over 100. 6:48 to go in the third, and Funk will throw. Funk down the middle of the field, caught again at the 13-yard line, Armstrong. This guy's got some sure hands in the slot. He has been tremendous tonight. I'd venture to say more catches tonight than in any of the first two games. Tequan Collins, the former Minnesota Spartan of the WAFL, is the backup running back for Louisville. I should have known. 6:18 to go in the third. Louisville's up 4. Out of the eye, Funk. Funk off his back. Foot nearly picked off. Had a shot at it. And Houston could not come up with the big turnover. Shark LeVay breaks it up. Should have had it. And we're seeing a lot of missed opportunities on both sides.
Second and 10
at the Hyena 13. Houston's defense looks like they're in a 4-4 here. Just one deep safety, that's Rockefeller. And the handoff will go to Collins. Collins past the 10! Collins past the 5! And Taquan Collins, the backup running back to Overstreet, scores! Ah, it's just unbelievable. Louisville's dominance. They're just, well, actually, it said Ahmad Price. That's a glitch everywhere. Taquan Collins, according to the Wolfpack owner, he knows best with the touchdown. And that dropped interception, some of this cross-conference file stuff you folks have to understand. That was towards the end of the offseason. Everyone in the SFL headquarters a bit tired. At that point, a lot of work goes into this as Louisville takes an 11-point lead. Collins on the touchdown, 31-20. Louisville with back-to-back scores in the first 5 minutes. Oh, actually, I stand corrected. That was Ahmad Price. We're really getting loosey-goosey here. The third string running back with the touchdown. That's insanity. Doesn't matter who you put in there for the Wolfpack. They're getting the job done in the third quarter. Vito on the return and met at the 27. And this Houston defense has crumbled here in the third, and they're near to giving up their 36 points a game average, which coming in was dead last. The SFL is presented by Dak Stats and OBS Studio, celebrating the league's seventh season here on Twitch TV. 6:03 to go, so a lot of time to go in this game. High formation, Abwaji's going to throw, and Abwaji goes deep. He's got a man wide open. It's dropped by Vincent. Overstreet's done for the night. That is the fourth drop by Houston, and they cannot catch a break. He was wide open. That had touchdown written all over it.
Great.
And Darnell Black has got to get back involved here. Houston getting a little too pass happy, and they just, no one's catching passes besides a D.R. Sim and Darnell Black. Black will take the handoff up the middle, and Black picks up 4 to the 31. Fourth drop ball that I've been able to count from the Hyenas tonight. 6 catches on 7 targets for Sim. Three receivers, 2 off to the right. Abwaji back to throw. And deep down the field. Oh, it's caught! Paul James at the Wolfpack 49 saves the drive. What a play by James. A shot right in the gut. Oh, that's right in the ribs. That's going to hurt tomorrow. I believe that was Gatlin with the big hit. What a play by James. Talk about coming up big for your team in a big moment. Two in the backfield. Back to pass. Abwaji. And he'll have to dump it off to Black. Black in the open field. We'll pick up just 3. For the Wolfpack 46, 4:50 to go in the third. Take a look at what's to come in week 4. It's rematch week. Baltimore heads to Orlando, a memory of the catch. Queen City at Houston, a rematch of last season's title game. Santa Fe and D.C., the play, a rematch of season 5's title game. All next week on the SFL family of networks. Black on the catch. It's third down and 4 coming up the Louisville 43. Also, some good rematches. Carolina-Tallahassee. Skyhawks want revenge for getting eliminated from the playoffs in Week 12 by the Pride. And Cleveland-Minneapolis, the Vipers came just shy of facing the Maulers in the first round. They were the only team before the Crabs in the playoffs to shut down that Mauler offense in the first half. And those two will play for the first time since that game. Black on third down and 4 will not get the first down. Khrushchev on the tackle. It's fourth down and 3, and Houston is forced to punt the ball away and hope their defense can find a pulse. Wolfpack have really turned it on here in the third quarter. They've always been somewhat of a second half team. And inside the 10, this punt's going to bounce down at the 4, roll to the 3, roll to the 2. A friendly roll for Houston, and maybe they can squander a safety out of this. First time Louisville's been pinned inside their 10-yard line tonight.
First and 10.
3:20 to go, third quarter. Other action across the league. NYC and Sioux Falls battling on SFLN 3. DC and Oklahoma City battling on SFLN 2. That pass on the outside is ruled a catch by Starbuck. 269 yards for Funk. A slightly better evening for Skeletor P. Funk. Abuazi, just a couple of bad passes. That one interception, not his fault, off the fullback's hands. He has not been helped out by his receivers tonight either. Second and 6 at the Louisville 6-yard line. Houston for a stop and a flip of some field position here to regain some momentum. Collins in the backfield. Overstreet is out of the game. Collins with the catch. Collins has a first down. Nobody paying attention. Oh, Overstreet is back in the game. Overstreet is back in the game. The injury report was wrong. I've seen it all. The injury report said it was an arm injury, but Overstreet is back in the game and gets a first down for Louisville. Well, you really start talking about luck not being on the side of the Hyenas, and that is some foolishness right there. Overstreet balling. This guy just doesn't go down. Funk back to pass. Funk pump fake now. Dumps it off short. Overstreet with the spin. A gain of 7. Second and 3 at the 24. Wow. And the chat's going insane with the drug rumors about that have lingered with this Louisville franchise for years, but no rumors have ever stuck as fact. Out of the eye, 2 minutes to go in the third, second and 3. Funk gonna flip it. He's sacked, and brutally so. Gets his head ripped off by Green, Tony Green, and watch this monstrosity of a play. Woo! Green tells Funk, the grass is greener. Take a look at it. A minute and a half to go in the third. Third down and 6 after the brutal sack. Funk to throw. Funk will flip it outside. It's caught again by Kirkland to the 31. This drive started at the 2. And Houston just can't get Louisville off the field. Still plenty of time left in this game, but Louisville scored 14 unanswered points in the third. They have an 11-point advantage. Funk back to throw. Funk will dump it off. Overstreet's doing the game. Picks up 1. You know, this isn't the first time. This isn't unprecedented that we've seen a player come back into the game who was ruled out. However, when they've come back in the game, and the Season 5 semi comes to mind when Overstreet returned, Overstreet looked hobbled. He looked, looked shaky, like he wasn't himself, but Overstreet looking pretty good right now here in the third. Funk back to pass. The pass is intercepted at the 40. Return pass the 30. Open field in front, and it's a touchdown, Houston! That's Ahmad Arrington with the score! And a game-changing interception by... my apologies, Aaron Arrington with the pick 6. I always get Ahmad and Aaron confused, so you have to forgive me. But Aaron Arrington with the pick 6. And Houston is back within 1 score. What a game. Third pick of the night for Funk. And it's been Pick Six City here in week three. What a play by the defense. The extra point is good, and it's Houston 27 and Louisville 31. Aaron Arrington, who's been pretty quiet over the first couple of weeks of the season, and in this game he did have a pass defended against Starbuck in the first half. He was money last year. He was so good last season. And we were wondering when Aaron Arrington would show up. As Armstrong returns to the 29-yard line. Coming up Sunday night, Baltimore heads to Orlando. Orlando 2-1, the Crabs 1-2. That's Sunday night, 7 Central. Also have Carolina, Tallahassee, and Cleveland, Minneapolis that night. Two in the backfield for Funk, a 4-4 defensive look. Funk is going to hand it off. Overstreet, he's got a lot of room, and Overstreet picks up 8. And that set has not worked against the run. Overstreet approaching 100 yards. He looks just fine out there. And he says, I'm sure he has some words for J.D. Lawson. You think you can put me down? I don't think so. Coming up on the end of a tremendous third quarter, Wolfpack by 4. Final play of the third, handoff to Overstreet, and he got nothing. In fact, lost a yard. That is the end of the first third quarter. Houston 27, Louisville 31. Strap in. Put your helmets on. Fourth quarter next. Start of the fourth, Funk down the middle, wide open. First down to the 47, that's Ritter. Take a look at the power rankings. Coming into the week, a top five look in how they've done this week. Santa Fe gets the win last night. Louisville and Sioux Falls in action. Tallahassee lost and Baltimore lost. Number 4 and number 5 respectively in the rankings. Be interesting to see how far they fall this week. Funk's pass is caught. 4-yard pickup. Rockefeller on the tackle. Kirkland with the reception. 10:18 to go. Another look at that top 5 from the power rankings. Who's moving up your power rankings this week? And if you're not a part of the power rankings voting group, contact at Doug Bose on Slack to find out how you can join them. 10 minutes to go in the third quarter. 3 receivers. Back to pass Funk. And Funk will pump it out down the field. That pass is caught to the 41. Ritter makes the play. First down, and Louisville's on the move again. The next scheduled programming for the SFL is Inside the SFL, only on TalkShoe every Saturday night, 8 Central, 9 Eastern. Host Doug Bose, Alan Drum, various call-ins and co-hosts joining the field throughout the season as Overstreet takes the handoff, gets 2 blocks, Overstreet 20, and inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. David Overstreet, this man tonight. First 2 weeks, everyone wondered why in the world are they not relying on David Overstreet anymore, and they can put those doubters to rest. Houston trying to keep this a one-score game with 9 minutes and counting. An unsuspecting return for Overstreet into this game has put a shot in the arm of the Wolfpack. That pass is caught on the outside by Starbuck. Gain of 6, second and 4 at the 8. If you're Houston, all you can think about right now is do not let him in the end zone. Help keep this manageable. 328 yards, three touchdowns, three interceptions tonight for Funk. Two in the backfield, handoff Overstreet. Overstreet inside the five, and he's going to score! They just don't stop, do they? Touchdown, Louisville. They're back up by 10, despite the pick six, and more work to do for the Hyenas. Still plenty of time left. Lawson had an opportunity at Overstreet, and he wasn't even close. Ezekiel on to kick the extra point. And the defensive points per game average for Houston's going to go down after tonight. Up, however you want to call it. Extra point is good. Houston 27, Louisville 38, 8:36 to go in the ballgame. SFL postgame show immediately follows the conclusion of this game and all games across the SFL family of networks, DC and Oklahoma City on SFLN2 and on SFLN3 tonight, NYC taking on Sioux Falls. We'll take your calls. From the nine, Mito on the return. And Mito, I thought he was going to get past the 30. Excellent tackle in the open field there. And the Hyenas will start from their 28. A wild night of SFL action. Houston still trying to stay alive. Both these teams giving up over 30 points a game defensively coming in. Empty backfield, five receivers. Darnell Black has disappeared from the Houston game plan, trailing in the second half. Abwaji's got to get rid of it. That pass is incomplete. Washington was the intended target. He's been looked at quite a bit tonight. And Abwaji just had to get rid of that because the pressure was all over him.
Great.
Second and 10.
8:29 left, second down and 10 at the 28. And Abwaji will throw. He'll hit Black. Black trying to make something happen in the open field, and look at all the gray shirts around him. Funk's over 300 yards. It's third down and long for Houston. And that last touchdown by David Overstreet may have just taking the last breath out of the Hyenas. They look a little gassed on this series. Abwaji to throw. Abwaji steps up, throws across the field. Oh, it's caught! It's caught by Sim! First down at the 41. Abwaji, I thought, had lost some brain cells throwing that ball across the field, the middle of the field, off the back foot, and Sim, around four or five Wolfpack defenders, makes a tremendous catch. Four receivers now. Seven and a half to go. Plenty of time. Black takes the handoff. Black gets a block, spins away from two, from three, from four. Darnell Black, ridiculous, to the Louisville 47. A highlight reel run that makes me dizzy. This is ridiculous. You got one? How about another? Okay, one more. Oh, you're not done? Alrighty, first down for Houston. What a run. Meanwhile, seven catches for a buck 24 for Sim. Under 7 minutes to play. Abwaji to throw. And Abwaji down the field. Caught with a block. So, what a play on the outside. Sanders makes one of the best defensive plays of the game. Sim had a touchdown. And watch the play Sanders makes to get off his block. This is pretty. This block, oh, he just crushed Paul James to make the tackle. Man, we have seen some individually fantastic plays tonight. 6:25 to go in the fourth. First and 10 at the Louisville 33. Back to pass, Abwaji. And Abwaji, deep ball, is caught at the 2! Sim again! Oh my goodness. This is just getting sick. Sim is, he's got Monk draped all over his back. First and goal at the 2. And Abwaji will hand it off to Darnell Black, and he didn't get in. No gain, in fact. Excellent stop. Under 6 to go. Houston down 11, but still fighting. 5:40 to go, and it's because of some sensational catches on third down and down the field. Black takes the... Oh, Black's out of the game. Loss of 3. Houston cannot figure out why Darnell Black is so winded on the goal line that he can't stay into the game. Talk about a difference between running backs. Black goes out on the goal line, and Overstreet comes back in with an injured arm. Third and goal at the 5 now for Houston. Abwaji will throw, and Abwaji goes end zone. The pass is caught for a touchdown. It's Paul James. Every time Houston needs a big play, they just come up with it. Paul James just runs a simple post to the back of the end zone, and nobody was back there. Now, will Houston go for 2 here? There's still 5 minutes left. No, they'll kick the extra point. A lot of time left in this game, and Houston just will not go away. And the extra point is good. Houston 34, Louisville 38. From Blue Sun Stadium in Louisville, Kentucky, you're watching the 0-2 Houston Hyenas battle the 2-0 Louisville Wolfpack, and Houston is doing everything they possibly can to try to save a victory here tonight. Kick is away. Armstrong on the return from the 10. Past the 25, Armstrong makes a few people miss to the 32. I am your exhausted play-by-play commentator, Cameron Irvine. And someone said in the chat, can we do Louisville and Houston every week? I just don't think that is physically possible. First and 10 at the 32. Can Louisville respond? And they have responded all night. Overstreet's pass is caught, but it's a 2-yard loss. Overstreet, 10 grabs tonight for 39. Kirkland quietly, 6 for a buck 29 and a touchdown. And that's a 2-yard loss blown up by Hamilton, who hasn't got a lot of mention tonight. Second and 12 for Louisville. 4:42 to go. Two receivers off to the left, ball close to the right hash. 4.5 to go. Split backs out of the shotgun, funk to pass. Swings it outside, pass caught. Receiver falls over, that's Kirkland's 7th grab. Clock continues to move. Lawson joined with Kirkland, 3rd and 7 at the 35. Oh man, if Houston gets the stop here. I tell you what, for all the drops that Houston has made, they've made just as many tremendous and difficult catches down the field. 4 minutes to go. Handoff Overstreet on third down, and Overstreet around the right side picks up a few to the 39, but Houston's defense gets the stop, and the offense will get the ball back with under 4 minutes to go.
Break!
Your wing has elected the punt. Number zero is D3C.
3:35 and counting. And Houston has a chance to take the lead, fighting back from an 11-point deficit in the third quarter. Azikiwe kicks it away from the 25. He don't want to return up to the 29-yard line. Steve Obuagi hasn't had the prettiest night, but man, he has come through in the clutch, and we talk a lot about the receivers making amazing plays, but he's putting the throws on the money, too. Two in the backfield, 3:12 to go. Will this be the final drive or final chance for Houston? Obuagi's pass is incomplete. Pressure in his face, and he nearly was sacked. Three minutes to go in the fourth. A four-point slim edge for Louisville. Four receivers, three off to the left for Houston. High snap, rolling left, and the pass is overthrown. He had a man wide open. I don't understand that. That was the perfect play call. Louisville was bringing pressure from the right side. Obuagi rolls away from it and then chucks the ball out of bounds. The receiver was wide open. Third down and 10 at the 29. Now under center with five receivers, three off to the left in a trip set. 3-2 defense, Obuagi to throw. Obuagi deep down the field, the pass is incomplete, and a number of players had a chance to make the catch. Fourth down. So now if you're Houston, you have all three timeouts. You're down by just four. I think you probably punt the ball away here, and that's what the Hyenas are going to do, but Louisville, certainly not the easiest team to stop. Houston's got their work cut out for them, but not a good drive for the Hyenas. Pressure on first down, a terrible pass on a good play call on second down, and then good coverage down the field on third down as Armstrong returns it up to the Wolfpack 42-yard line. With 2:43 to go in the ball game. If you like what you see, follow us on Twitter at SimulationFL. Subscribe to our YouTube and Twitch channels at /SimulationFL. And go to SimulationFL.com for daily website updates. We're going to get all of that updated after tonight's games. A very hectic, busy week three. Shovel pass starts the drive again, and Overstreet picks up seven. Louisville's run that on first down, I think, every time they've run that call tonight. But a big gainer on first down, and that gets Louisville one step closer to eventually winning this ball game. They do not have to snap it again before the two-minute warning. The play clock's at about 22 right now. Second and three at the Louisville 49. Three receivers. Houston has all three timeouts remaining. Trying to hold on to force a punt ASAP. And Louisville does not snap it. And we've come to the two-minute warning. This is the SFL Network. Second down and three at the Louisville 49-yard line. 2 minutes to go in the fourth, and Funk has empty backfield, five wide receivers. Talk about ballsy. Funk back to pass, going down the field. It's knocked away, and it stops the clock. Houston makes the play. Chad Foxwell down the field. Wow, I mean, they don't even show run. They don't even give Houston the impression that they're going to run. And the Hyenas save a timeout, and if Louisville does happen to get a first down. Houston can still get a stop because of that incomplete pass. Now it's third down and three at the Wolfpack 49. They go out of the eye. They would most certainly run this here. Although I've seen crazier things. And Overstreet, they're going to shovel it, and the pass is incomplete. The flag will be declined, and Houston wastes no timeouts and will get the ball back.
Ineligible receiver.
It's just, I never see the same thing twice in this league. It just blows my mind, and Louisville insanely cocky on those final two plays. And this is the third straight game that Louisville has done something or some sort of series or philosophy or moment in the game makes you think that Louisville, they're not going to win. They've won the last 2 weeks. Will karma finally catch up to the Wolfpack as Houston nearly blocks the punt? And a fair catch is called for at the 16-yard line by Mito. 84 yards for the win for Houston. And where have we been before? Where have we seen this before when these two teams were playing? Who would have thought that a rematch of the Teal Conference Championship game would have the ball in the hands of a different quarterback, but the same type of possibility for Houston to win the game? Rolling outside. This pass is much more on target, and Washington catches the pass for a 5-yard pickup. That was the play that Abwaji overthrew on the last drive. D.R. Sim, you got to feel like this is his drive and his moment. Of course, he had the game winner the last time these two played as the clock expired. 1:45 to go, second and five at the 21 for Houston. Abwaji straight back, dangerous play, and the pass is dropped over the middle. Fifth drop of the night for Houston. Man, just brutal every time. Every chance. Third and five. This is where Houston has made their magic down the field. Four wide receivers out of the gun. Abwaji. Third down and five. Back to pass. Abwaji's in trouble. He is sacked, and Houston has to burn a timeout. And honestly, I don't even know if they had to burn a timeout. Obviously, you want to regroup on fourth down, but Rick O'Reilly makes the sack. And now, I'm not even sure that you would get the ball back if you're Houston down to two timeouts. Fourth and 12. But, of course, we've seen Houston convert fourth downs before in this situation. Four receivers, three off to the left. Abwaji's going to roll. Oh, what a horrible play. What a horrible play. They have to get Terrence Washington out of the game plan. He has been targeted so heavily tonight, and he's not even a focal point of the offense. I've never seen a non-star receiver targeted so much, and that was about the worst straight four plays Houston's had consecutively all night. Now, two timeouts left. Houston still has an outside shot, possibly. But that was a horrendous play in the two-minute offense. Overstreet is hit behind the line, and Houston calls timeout. So the best the Hyenas can do probably is hope for a tie, unless Louisville decides they want to throw some more. SFL postgame show coming up next. Immediately following the conclusion of this game, the other two games have gone final. A lot to talk about and get through as week three, a wild week three, comes to a close. Oh my God. Louisville is in empty again. Funk is out of the gun, and he will throw to the end zone, and it's caught for a touchdown. They stuck it in their eye, and Brevin Armstrong scores and conceivably puts the game out of reach. What a disastrous 2 minutes for Houston. J.D. Lawson chasing Armstrong the entire play. But Houston get the ball back at least. You never know. This is the SFL after all. Armstrong with the touchdown late, and Louisville's got 44 on the board. And the Wolfpack have just rubbed it in. They are literally out of salt tonight. You think they're upset about losing the conference title game back-to-back years here at home and last year to Houston? I'd say so. Still 89 seconds left. You never know in the SFL. Houston has been trying to catch up to the Wolfpack the entire second half after that bad start to the third quarter. From the 7, Mito on the return, and Mito gets to the 27-yard line. So, this drive has to be better than the last one for Houston. They've called the same that same play three times in the last 3 or 4 minutes after not calling it all day. Just amazing. 1:22 to go. Abaji's out of the shotgun. First and 10. Back to pass. And a deep ball down the field is knocked away. Washington again was targeted. Maybe D.R. Sim got hurt or something. D.R. Sim has got to be the money man in this situation, or James or Vincent or somebody. And no disrespect to Terrence Washington, but you shouldn't care about him with 1:18 to go in the fourth. Sim is in the slot right now to the right side. Two in the backfield, Abaji to throw. And Abaji just flips it outside. Horrible two-minute offense. And it's amazing because they had a tremendous one-minute drive at the end of the first half. This has got to be the most frustrating loss in Hyena franchise history, even worse than the championship game, because Houston can't count how many times they had an opportunity to beat Louisville tonight. Third down and 11. On the last two drives, Houston has negative yardage, and they're sacked again! Houston has negative 17 yards on their last five plays, on their last six plays, and Tyler Gray comes up with the sack. Just let that stat sink in. Negative 17 yards on the last six plays. Seven plays, actually. Fourth down again, fourth and 20. Ball at the Hyena 17. Last ditch effort for Abaji. He's going deep down the middle, and the pass is incomplete. And what a fanatic finish by the Wolfpack defense. Aaron Tolbert knocks the pass away, and three kneel downs coming for Louisville, who once again escapes the jaws of defeat and will improve to 3-0. And this one's going to hurt Houston for a little while. SFL postgame show coming up immediately following the conclusion of this game. But for as good as Houston's offense was all night in the final eight plays, they go negative 17 yards, back-to-back four and outs. Not sure that I've ever seen that, as Skeletor P-Funk will take his first knee and the clock will begin to wind. So the Wolfpack go to 3-0, and they just continue to run through the SFL and scratch and claw their way to victory. It has not been easy. But David Overstreet coming back into the game right from injury. You have him throwing for it late in the ball game, and it ends up resulting in a Louisville touchdown. A third string running back gets a touchdown for Louisville tonight. All sorts of things in the end, bouncing Louisville's way. But Houston has a lot to be proud of. They came in here tonight and gave arguably the best team in the SFL, or one of the best teams, a serious run for their money. As the clock hits zeros. Final score, Houston 34, Louisville 45. The SFL postgame report is coming up in a moment. Stay tuned, 60 seconds away.